Welcome, sir. Mr. C. Balagopal is the chairman and managing director of Thermo Penpol. He was with Indian Administrative Service and has worked in various posts in Manipur and Kerala. He resigned from the IAS in 1983 to promote a joint venture company manufacturing innovative biomedical devices in India using indigenous technology. He has several awards to his credits, including the Management Leadership Award of Trivandrum Management Association in 1990, National R&D Award for Successful Commercialization of Indigenous Technology by Ministry of Science and Technology, Government of India in 1995, Outstanding Entrepreneurship Award from Kerala State Industrial Development Corporation 2011, Business Excellence Award 2011 from the Trivandrum Chamber of Commerce and Industry. TPL has been recognized by ISBTI and other national organizations for CSR activities aimed at promoting voluntary blood donation. Balagopal was the first president of Chai Kerala chapter and is currently a charter member. Pleasure having you here, sir. For the attention of the chair, please feel free to interrupt if the speaker exceeds the time limit. With that, let me request the chairperson to please kindly take over. Present session delegates. Thank you.
Good morning. It's my pleasure to chair this session on manufacturing with, of course, as you all know, the focus of this TICON is to throw up opportunities, entrepreneurial opportunities in various tracks. We have an entrepreneurship track, a services track, and then this manufacturing track and a couple of other tracks. So this will have four sessions today and tomorrow with the focus on manufacturing. And you know, the very fact that manufacturing is not taken very seriously in Kerala is, I think, reflected by the fact that we have such a thin attendance in this hall. Even, you know, when I look at KSIDC and KFC advertisements, I don't find any mention of manufacturing. They mention Ayurvedic spas and DTP centers and adventure tourism. And they talk about everything else except manufacturing. And that I find it extraordinary, because there are very many reasons why Kerala has got very unique advantages in manufacturing. And this is not something hypothetical or theoretical or some sort of crazy idea of somebody. And we are not talking about the future. And what we intend to do today is to present actually three cases of manufacturing success in this state. And I think it is best by hearing these first person examples that we try to understand how manufacturing can succeed in what is considered to be a difficult place for manufacturing. I do not propose to say too much by way of introduction, and therefore will reserve whatever comments I have for towards the end, because I would like to see that we get as much opportunity as possible for the speakers to present their viewpoints and for the audience to ask questions, because that is the real purpose of a TICON, is to enable this kind of interaction. And I hope that there will be interaction. And for good interaction, we don't need quantity. It is even with the few people who are present here, I'm sure we can have a very stimulating discussion. So without much ado, I think we'll go straight to the session. A couple of ground rules, I think they have been explained. So for the benefit of the speakers and the audience, I understand that you have been allotted 20 minutes each. You're not obliged to take the full 20 minutes, but you're encouraged to restrict your presentations to within 20 minutes so that we get some time for the... There is a clock there, so you will not be rudely interrupted by me to say that your time is up. You can always check how much time you have by just looking at the clock on the left, which is a countdown. And then the ground rules for the general discussion, for the audience participation, will be explained when we come to that part of it. So let me first invite the keynote speaker, Dr. Suresh Nair, who is currently President R&D of SFO Technologies. He is also the Chief Technology Officer of the Nest Group, and he heads R&D activities including product development. The Nest Group, as you all know, is one of the real success stories of Kerala, of entrepreneurship at its best in manufacturing as well as in software. In fact, what is very little known here is probably one of the biggest exporters of high-tech electronic products from India, any part of India, is the Nest Group from the Cochin export zone here in Kakinada, and SFO Technologies. We have the pleasure of dealing with SFO Technologies, so we know how much appreciation they have gained from most of the, from some of the world leaders like GE Medical, Philips, and other giants. And they are, you know, on a preferred supplier status, shipping their very high-tech imaging products to all parts of the world. Suresh Nair, he has led the Nest team in developing various healthcare products for customers. His innovative technology and business proposals have attracted many global customers, as I've mentioned before, like Philips and the GE. He's a gold medalist with an M.Tech in microelectronics with first rank and a PhD from the Indian Institute of Technology, Bombay. He started his career at the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research and later on was at Samir in the Ministry of Information Technology, Government of India. He was instrumental in setting up a design and engineering center for integrated optics at Samir with many first-time planar lightwave products in the country and was the key designer of the Indian MST radar. Gives me great pleasure to invite Suresh Nair to make his presentation.
Now I have 15 or 20 minutes.
No,
okay.
You have 15
minutes. So, good morning. Again, I think 2 more minutes for the good afternoon. Thank you very much for introducing me, and first of all, I would like to thank TI Kerala for inviting me. Being a very skeleton audience, but as you know, Mr. Balagopal was explaining, you know, it is, because hardware, the manufacturing is not taken as a major or serious business here. So I thought, like, I will start from a simple example, innovative product proposal. Always, you know, entrepreneurs are always looking for innovation. So we need to have some sort of a necessity, or we need to have a problem to find out a solution. That is the major rule. And here I am presenting a problem for all entrepreneurs here. The problem of an IT engineer, if you look at, they have to work almost 20 hours a day and hardly any time to sleep, because next day they have to again go and do work. So what solution we can give for this type of problem? One is, like, we can design a mouse which will automatically move the screens. You know, for example, you know, this is the situation of an IT school or IT organization, and the bosses will be going along the corridor, you know, looking at the screens where this fellow is working or not. So if we can come up with an auto-moving mouse, that will help them. They may not, you know, they can sleep, okay? The mouse will change the screen so that the boss will think, like, you know, it's very good, they are working. Now, that will not solve the problem of the employee, because they have to have some, you know, sleep. So this is another solution. You can see here, the eyeball stickers are available now. You can sleep, you put the eyeball sticker on the eyelid, so very cool, you can sleep. So this is also, this has got a lot of market, even in conferences, you know, after lunch, you know, a lot of people, and I always think, like, this type of sticker should be put in the box, the bag itself, you know, the kit itself. So coming to that one, I will straightaway get on to my job. The electronics manufacturing in India, you know, this is, the government has seriously looked upon what has to be done for this. And if you look at the survey says, like, you know, after a few years, the hardware import will be more than that of oil import. Okay, now the oil import is very much more, so this will overtake that. So government has come out with a policy where, you know, they are supporting in a big way. One aspect is the electronics manufacturing cluster, which has now come up. So I'm not getting into all the you know, details there. I have given here a department. If you look at the Department of Electronics and IT website, this has come up recently in paper also. What are the facilities they provide? How much money they are able to support? So they are really trying to, you know, support the hardware manufacturing. So it's sort of a cluster. So that's what I think, if you look at, a lot of northern states have already started looking into this. So this is, in Kerala, I have not seen any such proposal as of now, but there are opportunities to come up with this one. And included in this electronics manufacturing is the healthcare one. So if you look at the Indian healthcare business, the estimate is like, the prediction is like around 6.4 million billion US dollar business by 2020. So some of the major factors driving this growth in this sector is, you know all these things. I'm not getting into each and every of these items, like increasing population, growing lifestyle, cheaper cost for treatment, the trust in medical tourism, all those things. And as long as people are there, healthcare has to be there. You know, it's not a short term, like, you know sometimes in telecom and all, if you you know specialize in some area, you have a risk. Maybe after 5 years, that the technology may not be there. But in healthcare, you know, it's going to be there. So it's a long term business. It's a very good business to start also. If you look at the business possibilities, I divide it into services as well as products. You can get into services domain, or you can start developing products. So if you look into services domain, you can have design and development for others. So you are giving service to other customers. Manufacturing, so they already have a design, you are supposed to do only the manufacturing of that. ODM or private label. You may be having your own product. It can be private labeled. You need not have any sales and marketing. Okay, that is the advantage there. Then sales and marketing for others. Then distribution for other companies. And repair and maintenance for other companies. These are some of the areas or opportunities one can get into. But if you come to a product, you know, you can get into various type of products like diagnostic equipments, ultrasound, MRI if you are able to do. And there are a lot of machines, equipments now being developed for curing cancer, burning the tissues and things like that. Surgical equipments, test lab equipments, then biotechnology equipments, as well as research equipments. So these are some of the areas where, you know, you can concentrate on developing and getting into the business possibilities. So, as explained, SFO, or that's the flagship company of Nest Group, we are into these areas like services, where design and development, manufacturing, and ODM. So those are the areas where we are now concentrating on. So just to give an idea of what we do and the various activities we do, we established this company in 1991, so around 21 years old. And, you know, we offer end-to-end solution, including research and development, that is even technology development, product development, then product engineering, embedded and application software, which comes as part of the product engineering, electronics and mechanical manufacturing here, and also system integration. So, instead of getting into all these details, just to give an idea of what we do, and we are, I think, the third largest EMS companies in India. This came out in October 12 issue of Electronics Bazaar. But really, if you look at the first two companies are Sanmina and Jabil. They are basically multinational companies. They are not Indian companies, basically. So we come first in this area here. And if you just wanted to have a view of our facility here, it's only a 5-second video. I shortened it. So this looks something like this. These are all the SMT, surface mount machines, and all the processes what we have here. Okay. So, and if you look at the product what we manufacture, it may not be known here because we are basically in the export market. So we work in all these areas like ultrasound, X-ray, MRI, then CT, surgery, and ECG, maternal infant care, as well as clinical products. So I just put a few pictures here, you know, some of the industrial designs we have done, some of the power supply subsystems what we have done, some of the user interfaces what we have done, some of the accessories like RF products which we develop, some of the control hardware. We also do the compliance testing. It is not that we have all the facilities, but we facilitate getting the compliance testing done here. So, now you look at everywhere all over the globe, everybody is going towards China for anything you want. So this is one cartoon which I have seen here. There was a board saying, to cut costs, we have moved the clinic to China. So please take a ticket for your flight coupon and go to China. So that is the type of thing which is now being done. You know, whatever you want, go to China. So then, how can we compete in this world where, you know, China is approved as a low-cost manufacturing facility. The one area where we can concentrate is IP protection. Why customers are coming to us rather than going to China for these type of products is IP protection. So one of the news item which came up here was Volkswagen engine was being made in China as a contract manufacturer. Okay, after some time they see that the contract manufacturer, they themselves come out with the engine. So these type of things, these are the, some of the tricks what we apply, what we show to the customer and say that, see, come here and you know we will protect the IP. And we will show a lot of examples of how to protect IP and things like that. Then now, those are all general thing, but you as an entrepreneur, you will be looking at what I have to do or how much investment I have to do if I want to set up an electronics manufacturing facility, what we have done, what we have. Of course, we have set up the facility over 20-21 years, but if you want to start with, if phase one, maybe like through-hole components, that's a normal components with the leads, you just solder and start developing those type of circuit boards where you require a manual placement, maybe a microscope and a people trained, wave soldering, then a hand soldering for any components which are like connectors and big components, and you have a functional test setup. So with this type of equipment, you will be able to start an electronics manufacturing facility here. So a lot of people have started like that and then they have grown. But of course, we need to move to phase two because now people have stopped using through-hole components. Everyone wants surface mount components, all high technologies, even ICs are not having these type of leads. They are all having ball grid under the IC. So you need to get geared up for that one, but that can be a phase two thing where the equipments involved are screen printing, then of course thickness measurement for that one, then a pick and place machine which is very expensive of the order of 1.5 crores, then a reflow one. So what you do is like you put a screen printing, the machine will keep pick and place all the components at proper places, then you put a reflow so that it gets soldered there. So these are some of the things what you need to go for, you need to do to get into the phase two thing. So basically SFO Technologies, which is having around 1000 crore turnover now, we are having a replication or duplication of these setups only. Basically these setup only. And in addition to this, you need to have general facilities like labeling, then packing, like in EST bags, then quality control, sourcing, logistics, and things like that. So these are some of the things what you need to set up if you really want to get on to starting a manufacturing facility. So I need to give a ballpark figure of the cost also. And normally, the setup can be very small, of the order of 15,000 square feet area you can start with. The phase one, which I have shown earlier, with the manual placement and all, it comes around sort of the order of 60 lakhs. So if you have 60 lakhs, you may be able to set up the manual assembly line and start taking some business and grow. The second one is phase two, which may call for another additional, 100 lakhs of the order of 1 crore. And the building can be rental to start with, and other infrastructure around 40 lakhs. So totally, if you want to do phase one and two, the estimate is of the order of 2 crores. Then there are opportunities to find out second-hand or refurbished equipments. These are all available in the market. You need not go for a new machine initially. You can get all these things as a refurbished equipments. If you really wanted to make some business, work business, then you should have at least 5 crore worth of business. So that, if your investment, you can put this much, and then if you can get that type of business, then that will be worth doing. Then you also wanted to know what is the type of margins you have normally for electronics manufacturing, setup or the services. The type of margin is around 5% only. Okay, so don't think like you will have very high margin because we are competing with other people like in China, Vietnam, Philippines, and other things. Then, now what are the opportunities? That this also you would like to know what I can do. And what is possible here. See, you can see that the imported equipments normally have so many features and frills, and they are very expensive. And there are possibilities that you can develop India-specific products for this one, you know, without any frills, come up with a low-cost but still quality machines. And you can see that a lot of entrepreneurs have already started these type of things. I know a lot of people here who have started this one, but we need to be careful. One is like the innovation. Always I used to, you know, emphasize on innovation. That's where we can stand in front of China. Even though you have some innovative idea, it is not correct to assume that your innovative product will always find good market. You can see that some of the innovative products are not finding good market, whereas normal products can find good market. So you need to really do an analysis and then come to a conclusion. But probability of success for innovative products is always high. Then here, whenever you look at any other machine which is imported, you always feel like I can duplicate that, I can make a cost-effective thing. But you need to be very careful, any infringement of intellectual properties. These are all patented, these are all, you know, already IP is filed, so you need to be very careful while you want to duplicate something. So what you need to do is like you understand the product, but you come up with some innovation and then come up with a new product. That is the only way. So it is very, very important because you can be sued. Then approvals and certification. For example, we are talking about the healthcare products. Approvals and certifications are very important. So earlier, you know, other countries, they used to bring equipments for human testing here. But now it is not possible. A lot of rules and regulations have come up here. So you need to be very careful on that. And also clinical trials. If you want to do any clinical trials, that also you, there are process in place, like you need to get to ethical committee approval and things like that. It has to be in a normal way. So these are some of the issues what one has to face when you think of developing a healthcare product. I will show one case study here. This is for Narayanan Dera, is one of the famous hospital in Bangalore. So Dr. Devi Shetty, once you meet him, you know, you will never forget. He's, you know, he talks more engineering than medical. So I happened to be there, and he said like he is importing these type of life guides. These are simple equipments, and he pays around 90,000 rupees or something like that. And after 4 months or so, it goes back. So he gave me a sample, and we tried to understand what are the things there. And you can see there the top bottom, which is developed by us. Actually, there we try to understand what is done in the other one. It is not just direct copying. We try to improve the performance. You can see the performance what we have shown here. So we try to improve the performance, and now we are selling or we are giving to them for maybe up the order of 10,000 rupees. So, you know, with a profit margin. So these type of things are available if anyone wants to take up. So put some innovation, get out of the infringement issues, and then you will be able to successfully come up with it. And now it is just with a manufacturing facility, it is very difficult to survive. Of course, this is at a later stage of your entrepreneurship. But you need to give more and more value add to the customer. That's what I am showing here. These are the services what we provide to the customer. We try to provide more and more customers. It's not just manufacturing. Design, certification, reliability testing, all those things, proto build, all those facility value adds we need to give. So then the strategy what we have planned now, which is very successful, is that provide a product lifecycle support. Whenever a customer comes to you, he's not coming only for a one-time job. So you need to have a capability to provide a product lifecycle support. So the graph which I have put is a lifecycle of a product. So at every phase, you will be able to support him. So these are some of the tips which you know, helps us to keep the business growing. And as I explained earlier, you know, like regulatory, support them in regulatory compliances, reliability tests and things like that. It's not like you can make any device and leave with it. You need to do a lot of, you know, testing, like reliability testing. Every key has to withstand maybe 1 million operation. So you need to really do the test and then go for this one. As well as the ESD testing. This is one of the pain area for any customer, for any designer too. So once you make a device, you do the ESD testing and then, you know, give the certification on customer's name. Then the four points you need to take care is on-time delivery, quality, cost competitiveness and productivity. Productivity means like year over year, you need to give some advantage to the customer. Okay, the cost can come down. So you need to do something for that. I'm finding only 2.5 minutes here, but I will just flash through some of the slides. We can discuss further when after the talk. So these are some of the areas which makes us have some advantage over others, like have some unique business models. These all can be thought over, what we can give more than the other people. So these are some of the techniques which we have applied, we have been successful in this one. So this is our vertically integrated manufacturing. We did not stop with the electronics PCB manufacturing. We went on mechanical manufacturing. We went on fiber optics manufacturing. We went on, cable and wire harness manufacturing. So all those things we went on adding the vertical integration. The advantage is like, the customer will not have a margin stacking at every stage. For example, if I am getting a mechanical from somewhere else, there will be a margin stack there. So this will be loaded to the customer. So we wanted to avoid that, have everything within us. But of course, this can be at later stages. Then the quality certifications, ISO 9001:2008, this is a preliminary thing which one has to have. ISO 14001, now people are very much aware about the environmental one. ISO 13485, this is specifically for healthcare. This basically talks about the traceability and also, patient safety and things like that. Employee health safety and approvals. And one more thing I wanted to give a caution here. We can see that a lot of academic institutions as well as research institutes normally say like we have a lot of IP, why don't you come and commercialize that? So I had the experience of exploring how it is, but I have to caution you, very rare chance that this can be directly commercialized. You can expect to do a lot much more to get a reliable result, a repeatable result and a cost competitive product. So this is what I have seen. I'm not saying like everywhere it is like that, but this is a normal tendency. Even if some institute says like I have an IP, be careful. You need to work hard to get it commercialized because their mindset is different than the commercial mindset. This is what I will stop here. Every day, we are faced with challenge of being chased by our competitors. So every day we have to think how to do it. What I can do is like, I'm a zebra. I can project it as I am the low-cost manufacturing and things like that, and I can get on to the other, lead the other one. But then that is not okay. So what we need to look at is like this type of level, where, you are somewhere very high up, where your competitors can just look at only. This can be achieved only through innovation, cost competitiveness, and quality. So any direction, I already past the time, only 1 minute here. The directions are like future directions one can take is innovation to realize equipments for masses. That is very important. Then smartphone, tablet based, everyone uses that one. Now I have seen that even microscopes are coming with smartphone. So that you just put an attachment and you can get all the details. Then those are some of the areas which are coming up now. Then cancer detection is another area where I am also applying. I am working now. Non-invasive detection, then biomarkers, then handheld low-cost diagnostics, and also, it's not like you need to initially have all the equipments in your facility. You can, outsource some of them, and slowly you can build. So you need to have only idea, then you can outsource to other people for some of the areas, and slowly you can build those things. These are some of the government schemes. Government is very, it has got a lot of schemes to motivate. These are some of these schemes where you can get funding. Okay, from TEP funding you can get 15 lakhs, then second phase 35 lakhs. BIRAP is another one funding up to 50 lakhs for ideas. I'm just talking about only ideas. Then DBT project, DYIT, so all those things are there. So I will stop here and basically three apples have changed the whole world. First one, Eve had, the apple seduced Eve. That was the first one which changed the whole world. Second one was Newton, which fall on Newton's head. And third one with Job Steves. And the fourth one maybe with you. Thank you very much.
Any questions now? What I suggest is because You know, I suspect that the three speakers will be talking the theme, though they will be talking about different enterprises and different engineering challenges and different products and different issues in that sense. But ultimately, the approach is going to be the same. So I suspect that it will be better that we go through the three presentations, and then we'll have the Q&A, because many things will be common, and more than one speaker may like to respond to some of your questions. So let me move on to the second speaker, Mr. C. Padmakumar, Executive Director of Terumo Penpol Limited. Terumo Penpol is a pioneer in the Indian blood bag industry. Padmakumar started his career as a junior project executive in the company and worked his way up from the shop floor. He's also promoted director of Enter Technologies Private Limited, which is a medical transcription and medical BPO company. His interests are quality management.